So the first approach that I wanted someone to talk about was pitch-based systems for improvising. Just one example of course, endless systems for organising pitch, but one example I wanted to talk about was using 12-tone rows, so from serial composition, for generating new material for improvising, and ways in which you can construct those. So that there are lots of kind of ways in which you can construct a tone row. Finding ways in which you can do it in the context of an improvisation is kind of another matter. So I found it useful to just use familiar materials that you can construct tone rows just by piling certain intervals on top of each other. Pianists all know that language inside out. For saxophonists, typically that's a bit more practice, it's not made out for you. So interval-based tone rows, or even using very familiar tone materials, if you plonk a minor pentatonic on top of a major scale in a certain combination, then it covers all 12 notes, and that's a really easy way of just accessing the kind of 12-tone-ish area. Also, I work in jazz education as well. I teach saxophone students, and sometimes when I'm practicing this stuff, I kind of think about how I might explain it to them. So ideas like major scale, minor, pentatonic, interval construction is kind of useful in that context as well. So some caveats about this approach. Just think generating a perfect 12-tone row in which you don't repeat any notes in the throes of an improvisation isn't realistic, and it's not the point either. It's more just practicing these kinds of materials so that you can access that kind of a sound world in the context of an improvisation. In terms of how this chimes with Andy's idea of an aesthetics of imperfection, it's kind of a bit of a grey area because it borrows from a perfected medium from serial composition. And as I just said, it's never exact. You don't construct immaculate tone rows when you're improvising in groups. But the sort of general sound world of constructing melodies or pitch-based ideas that avoid repetition, avoid no repetition.